Let's focus now on the last exercise that we have for the wind turbine class. So in this exercise, we want to assess the inertial response of the wind turbine and see how much we can actually affect the frequency in the system whenever we have a load event or generation event and so on. So we will set the machine at 3 megawatt. We will initiate the dynamic by having a very large load event, actually, so it's 100% increase from 100 to 200 megawatt, and we run the simulation for 20 seconds. And then we see the influence of the different gains in the controller in order to see how much we can, how much kinetic energy we can actually pull out of the rotor of the wind turbine and support the frequency dynamic in our system. So let's actually go into Powerfactory. I already preset the machine and I already preloaded a load event so that we have a 100% increase at t equal to zero. We perform the dynamic and we have the usual frequency event that we are well familiar with. So at this point, we can actually utilize the nice feature that comes with the study cases in order to store different results, because we want to make a comparison between different situation in the system. So I'll just make a new plot where we are saving the frequency, the active power from the conventional unit, and also the active power from the wind turbine. There it is. Yes, so the first thing we can already appreciate is that, of course, the wind turbine itself will not really provide any kind of inertial response. So except for this very initial spike, which is suddenly damped by the controller, then the output of the wind turbine will remain to 3 megawatt. And of course, it's the conventional unit that is doing all the job. So at this point, we can create a new study case where we can save the new type of simulation. So I'll just make a copy of this study case and I'll call it case one, inertial controller. And then I activate that. Then at this point, I need to make sure that the result variable are pointing to the new study case. And then I can actually do some changes in our controller in order to see how things are behaving. So for instance, I may want to activate the slow part of the controller. So I already made a kind of tuning of my controller and I know that this kind of gain and this kind of time constant of the filter is reasonably okay for the job. So I'll rerun the case. And now we have the new situation. So I'll just print again also the previous case. So the one that was related to the previous simulation event, I'll use a different color. And at this point in time, as we discussed the last time, it is actually quite useful to have different colors for the different cases so that you don't mess up the information between the various simulations. So in this case, I'll keep the first simulation with the blue, with the red, with the black, and then the second one with the blue. So that one is gonna be in blue and this one is gonna be from the whole calculation here, and then we can actually see what's going on. So the first thing that we can see is that there is actually a difference from the wind turbine point of view. So the presence of this filter is triggering a sort of inertial response from the wind turbine. And then we have to be careful on what we intend as inertial response. So The filter is designed in such a way that is activated based on DF in DT, so it's a derivative filter. So we sense the derivative of the frequency and then we respond proportionally to this derivative with a certain delay. Then how large is the delay and how large is the gain is going to make actually the difference in the shape of this curve. So right now the machine is responding very fast because we can see here that the dynamic is happening between 0 and 4 seconds. You could say that it could be a sort of fast frequency response rather than an inertial response because it's not really participating in the inertial domain, which generally would include just the very beginning of the transient, so the first 100 of milliseconds. But still, since it's responding to a DF in DT, then we tend to classify this one as an inertial response. The other important information that we get out is that since the controller is responding to a DF in DT, as long as we have a negative, so as long as we have a decrease in the frequency, then the controller will set the machine to release, so to generate more power, and that's what we want. In the moment that we have actually an increase of the frequency, then the controller will do the opposite job. And actually this is quite important and useful because in the end, since this is a wind turbine, so we don't really have a control on the prime mover, we can't increase the wind speed, so we can't increase the power output of the machine. In the moment that we release a certain amount of kinetic energy, we need to make sure that this kinetic energy is recovered. And of course, this happens by temporarily reducing the amount of production. So the key point of this type of inertial response is that we are giving an extra amount of energy, so this power for this amount of time, to the system in order to support the frequency dynamic, but then we need to take back this energy from the system. This type of control is fairly simple, and other type of controllers could be more elaborated and a bit more sophisticated, but the principle remains the same. You can also see that actually we are not really affecting that much the frequency dynamic in the system. We need to be aware that we still have one wind turbine that is 7 megavolt ampere versus an entire larger conventional unit that is actually 600 megawatt. So it's also a fair, an unfair comparison in that sense. So in order to make it a bit more interesting, we can actually try to put more machines in parallel. So let's say that we want to have 20 machines. So all these 20 machines now will behave exactly in the same way. So what is Power Factory doing is just getting the dynamic of the individual machine and then multiplying by 20 the various output. We can now appreciate a bit more what's going on. So the first thing to be aware is that, of course, in this case, we are comparing the power output of a machine with the power output of 20 machines. So if we want to make a fair comparison, then we would need to normalize one of the two outputs. So in this case, that could be, for instance, 0.05. So that's 1 divided 20. Actually, the other way around. So that's 20, the normalization value, so that we can get it on the same scale. Okay, so keeping in mind that we have now a different base. We can see there is some difference also in the conventional output. So the first thing is that since we have more wind turbines, the initial power of the conventional unit will be lower. And then we can also see that in terms of contribution, it will be slightly different in terms of power at this point in time, because we are actually getting a little bit of relief in the frequency dynamic, or we are getting a little bit of support in the frequency dynamic from the wind turbine. So that's actually proving that it's working. Of course, we can't expect miracles in the end, but it can provide some useful support. Let's see now also another case where we have the other type of controller actives. Also in this case we will make a new study case. So we'll rename this one as a case 2. And we activate the study case. We make sure here that we are still plotting the information. Then we will have a new curve. So we will skip the conventional unit. We put a new color in our system. And then we need to make sure that actually we are not plotting the same information twice. Otherwise, Powerfactory will of course complain. So again, I'll take the new line, new color as well, and the same for the wind turbine down here. Here. And at this point, I'll rerun it again, making sure, of course, that since I want to create a new model, then I also need a new study, then I also need to change the controller. So at this point, I want to test the other controller, so the one that is saying k fast and t fast equal to 10 and 0.1. So I'll rerun the dynamic, and that's what we experience right now. So we can actually zoom it a little bit better here. So what are we experiencing now is that since I changed the characteristic of the controller, we are forcing the machine to release power more quickly. So at the very beginning of the dynamic. So that would actually be much closer to be an inertial response. But also in this case, we still have the fact that we are giving some energy to the system, which then we need to take back in order again to reaccelerate the machine and go back to the initial point. Why actually do we need to reaccelerate the machine? It's just because we want to run at the same speed. It's not just the speed for the sake of having the same speed, but it's also because the speed, given the same wind speed condition, which most likely will not change in this very short amount of time, if we are changing the rotational speed, most likely we will also take the machine into a different efficiency point. And this efficiency point could be actually lower. So in the end, we would reduce also the production of the machine. So yes, we would be able to give some kinetic energy, but as a steady state contribution, it would be lower. So that's why we need also to take back the rotational speed as it was before, because then we would take back to the optimal output of the machine. You can actually appreciate a bit better here in the frequency dynamic what's going on. So you can see that actually the brown curve, so which is the last one that we created, the frequency trend actually got a little bit better. So we see that the dynamic, the frequency decrease is actually smaller compared to the other cases. The last point, and of course we can do the same reasoning also by changing the inertia in the system. The last point which I would like to bring the attention on is actually what would happen if instead of having a DFIG machine, we would have a type 1 or type A wind turbine. So would that type of response be different compared to a DFIG? So the answer is yes, and let's actually verify that in Powerfactory. So what do we need to do now is a fairly simple trick. So we can actually take out of service this machine, just make a copy so that we have an identical machine We can actually make a copy also of the type, and I'll show you why we need to make a copy of the type. So this one, we will call it actually this one we will call it once more, yes, just induction generator, 20 kilovolt. And why I need to create a new one? I need to create a new one because right now I will not make a complete copy of the dynamic model, but I will just attach a fairly simple induction generator. And for me, that will be a good representation of a type 1 wind turbine. The only key difference that I need to do is that I need to include the inertia of all the turbine, so both blades, rotor, and generator, into the generator. I know that for this type of machine, the overall acceleration time constant is around 8 seconds. So what I need to do is just to increase 10 times the moment of inertia of the generator itself. So I'll call this one WT2. I will say that it's a standard asynchronous machine. And I'll again keep 20 machines. I'll put it in service. And I will keep the same operating point. So also for this machine, now I need to specify, and of course I need to take out of service also the frame of the DFIG, because it will not accept that I have taken out of service the element without taking out of service the frame. So also for this machine, I can actually define the result set. And once more, I can create a fourth case. So here, I'll just deactivate this one. And I will make a copy, paste. So this one, we call it case 3, and we call it just induction generator. Activate once more. And also in this case, I'll need to make a copy of the calculation as well. At this point, I'll change color. I will remap correctly all the values. So also this one down here, this one go back to the case number 2. This one stands, I'll change the color here. And I'll do the same for the last one, keeping in mind that my last variable is actually the new wind turbine power output. And I'll take this one here. So at this point, I can rerun my simulation. Yes, so what do we have here? We have that we can actually appreciate a bit better how would, let's say, standard induction machine respond in term of inertia support. I can make this one a little bit larger, not really. Okay, maybe I can put it like this. This one will be more visible now. So what do we have here? We have that the induction generator, a normal induction machine generator, would start to respond with this kind of shape. So as any kind of rotating machine would start to respond, as long as we don't have any power converter that is trying to prevent this kind of inertial response, such as the case of the WFED induction generator. So in this case, the machine would tend to respond much more in terms of inertial response compared to the DFIG, and of course also compared to any kind of virtual inertia service from the DFIG. And that would be about this last case. Of course, other variation can be tested seeing how the system would evolve if we have different age in our system, so that the virtual inertia provision from the wind turbine could actually get more consistent in the moment that the conventional unit has a smaller inertia. That's about it.